locate, also known as John Chang. And again, the name, also known as John Chang or Dynamo Jack.
Give us the name one more time. We have the entity. He is somewhat protected here, but we have him.
Yes, this man practices Mopai Ne Kung. It's a meditation discipline. He's considered very advanced by most people. There is a video showing him setting paper on fire with his chi. In other words, pyrokinesis. Is he actually capable of this, or is this just a parlor trick?
We see the entity is capable.
Okay. Would he be considered an avatar, or at least extremely advanced?
Understand, there is in the good book a story of Moses confronting Pharaoh and Pharaoh's magicians. Both are capable of commuting matter or transforming from one to another. Pharaoh's magicians took their staffs and converted them into two serpents. Moses took his and converted it into one. And then Moses' staff gobbled up the magician's two. The indication here is that humans, as you know, humans have ability and they can transmute or have power over physical things, the same as that it would be of one who is an avatar. The avatar, the force behind that one who is on the side of light or good, has a superior strength. Humans have godlike powers, but those that are in harmony with God have the greater power. This is the meaning behind that of the two serpents being swallowed or gobbled up by the one. Therefore, yes, humans can develop and have dominance over the world, can do those things you have addressed, and they can be powerful, but they are not as great or as powerful as one who is, let us say, anointed with the divine. Black magic or telekinesis or transmutation or transformation of matter is very much within the realm of humans, as you know humans. But the greater power comes from creation itself. And this is, with this understanding, this force, this power, this comes from the Almighty. It is the superior force because it is the creative force. Humans create constructively and destructively. The creative force only creates and continues to create. Although there are cycles of life and death, Alpha and Omega, everything in its season. This is in harmony. What humans produce is not in harmony. And this would be that is considered the fallen angel or Lucifer's dilemma or assertion. One who is skilled and is of the highest vibration or the creative force, God Almighty, they have the superior way, power, or control, for they are of light and the other is of darkness. Never fear, but do understand that the human soul can be a co-creator and demonstrate its godlike power or ability, the creative force, you'll say. But that one who is anointed or conjoined with the Almighty, can overcome any of the human creative forces, you'll say, because it is the divine within, truly an avatar, a spiritual being, a human being fully realized and awake as a spiritual being. And this would be the highest experience any human could hope for, yea, would desire and become, you'll say. Like Moses, authority from on high, to be in harmony with God Almighty, then whatever humans develop or demonstrate, their force, their ability is lesser, always direction.
John Chang has this entity, he has stopped teaching. Briefly, do you see any of his intentions for the Mopai school or lineage?
There seems to be some gap or some purposeful delay. It appears this intention is to see if the place can stand on its own. The entity is also becoming quite concerned with the chaos that is taking place in the world and is uncertain or has definite ideals, put it that way, as this being a time of uncertainty and extremes, to withdraw from the teachings. This would be his choice, he'll say, whether he is carnate or incarnate. You know. However, we can see this maintaining at least the facility for some time, and then we see some sort of activity taking place here. Call it an interruption or a recess, but there is and will be one who will attempt to resurrect the school, you'll say. Direction.
At the beginning, when I had you locate him, you said he was somewhat protected. Could you briefly elaborate?
This would mean that we cannot intrude upon his welfare or his thoughts, for the entity is fully aware of our conversation and what is taking place, as any who would be skilled in the matter. Protected, meaning he cannot be intruded upon or cajoled or manipulated. He is dense in his own spiritual, call it, consciousness. You might see it as a shell in which yourself or anyone else would cocoon themselves into as they would have awareness that they are not subjected to any random inquiry, thought, or influence. Direction.